Hey guys, welcome back. Okay, so this is going to be a review on Assassin's Creed 4 and just kind of my impressions and what I liked about the game and my recommendation on it. So we're going to start off, first of all, if you played an Assassin's Creed game, you probably already picked this game up or are planning to, and I recommend it. If you're already a fan of the franchise, definitely pick this game up. It's definitely going to do you a lot of fun. If you've never played an Assassin's Creed game, and you're thinking about breaking into the franchise, because obviously there are a whole lot of games out there, and some of them go back quite a few years, that you don't really want to, you know, you may not want to go back and play an older game. This is a good one to break into the franchise with, because it's not a direct linear successor to the previous one, and its storyline is tied to, but not one where you have to play the previous one to enjoy this one. So it's a great one to break into. So we'll talk about a couple aspects of the game. First one we're going to talk about is ground combat, which, unless you've been living under a rock, you've at least seen some of the Assassin's Creed games, video and gameplay footage. This game plays pretty much the same way as far as ground combat goes. A lot of free running, climbing, hiding and stuff, stealth assassinations, all that fun stuff, and little trinkets and doodads to do that with. So that's all pretty much par for the course for an Assassin's Creed game. What this one really does that's a little bit different that I loved was the naval combat. Now, the naval combat in this game was very, very well done. It really, really makes you feel like you're piloting a pirate ship, and, you know, just the fluid, everything just flows well with it. So, you know, you're obviously a pirate, obviously, as I just said. So you do all the normal stuff pirates are going to do. You're going to go on the high seas, you're going to find ships, attack them, and you're going to gather resources. The resources are going to be used for you to upgrade your ship. Your ship upgrades pretty much just like a character does. So you can get new armor, weapons, you can change the appearance of your ship. The ship I'm using actually has black sails because I thought that kind of fit more with the pirate motif. A lot of the missions take place in the ship. Most of the game, you're actually going to be on the ship sailing. There's also craftable stuff. You can make things using different pelts of animals you find on islands, or you can actually hunt sea creatures, such as orcas, whales, great white sharks, and even sperm whales. They're a great white whale. So that's all kind of cool. Different ship types in the game, gunboats, frigates, schooners, man-o-wars, which are a pain in the butt, as well as when you unlock some of the areas, you actually get the named ships, which are much, much harder to fight than the normal ones. Now, I did mention when you unlock areas of the map, you'll do that by doing things like destroying fortifications or forts in the game. You'll do that, and that's a combination of naval combat mixed with ground combat. That's pretty good. Storyline-wise, the game is good. It's a well-done game. As with all of them, the storyline keeps you engrossed, makes you want to know what's going to happen to the characters. I was a little disappointed in the fact that the game kind of ended, and I wanted more. I really, really wanted more story from the main character. But, whatever. That's kind of what I get, so, I can still want more, and I'm really looking forward to the next installment, expansion, DLC, whatever it is they decide to put out for this. It's going to be a lot of fun. This game does have multiplayer. I have not really had a chance to mess with the multiplayer in this, to be honest. I was very, very, really, really just too engrossed in the single player storyline. And the nice thing is, if you do finish the game, which I did today, I will recommend letting the thing play through the end of the credits just to see all the stuff that it does do for you and to get achievements and all that good stuff. So I do recommend you do that. But I did like that when the credits were done and it played through, it did put you back in the Caribbean with your ship so that you can go back and explore all that stuff that you maybe didn't do. If you're like me, I don't tend to be a perfectionist when I'm playing through the game the first time. I want the story, and I'll do some of the little side stuff as I see it. So it's kind of nice that I can now go back and visit these islands and do all of that stuff. But anyway, so the game is out on all platforms. It's next-gen systems, current-gen systems, as well as PC. I did have a little trouble getting some of the footage, so if some of this gets a little jumpy, it's because the PlayStation 4 output is actually copyright-protected. It is something they said they are going to work on and fixes they can get people that will do want to do gamer playing and let's plays. But as of right now, I guess it's kind of low on their priority list. So I kind of had to do a recording of a recording display. So it got a little glitchy. Anyway, Naval Combat Act 2, that one of the things you get to do when you take over an enemy ship is you actually board it, and then it goes from the naval combat into like more of a ground-based style combat, you know, where you're doing more of the free running, climbing up on the riggings, and, you know, killing the crew and doing whatever is required to actually take the ship. But it's what they do with after that that I thought was kind of cool. So you get three options basically when you take a ship. You can repair your current ship from the battle, which is always kind of nice if you take a lot of damage. Second one is you can lower your wanted level, because obviously you will have a wanted level. You're attacking ships. They actually send pirate hunters after you when you start getting a wanted level, but I'll be honest, I really didn't have much trouble fighting off pirate hunters. They were just kind of more of an annoyance at most times. Anyway, the third cool thing, though, the third option is you can send it to your fleet. They actually give you the option where your character will actually amass a fleet of ships. You don't actually get to see them in the game. They're just more of like, it's like a little mini game down the that you can do. But what makes it kind of cool, though, is that mini game is accessible from a smartphone app. So when you are not at your computer or at your game system playing, and let's say you're at work, you can actually log into your Ubisoft account through that app. You can actually access your fleet and send your ships on missions, like to do trade routes or to defend the trade routes and earn items that will actually make you money that you can use and then purchase other stuff in the game. So I thought that was kind of a nice little feature that they added in there. So that's pretty much going to be it for my review on it. I mean, the game is solid. I found very few bugs or unplayable things. There was one really big one at the end of the game, where the last person you have to assassinate kind of bugged out. Like, I landed on him, but it didn't register me hitting him, so I ended up having to desync myself and then start over again. A couple people got caught in rocks, but that stuff's kind of par for the course with most games. You're always going to find, if you look hard enough, some bug or some glitch. Other than that, the world is massive that you can sail in, so there's lots of stuff to do. It's a lot of fun. It's going to give you lots of enjoyment playing it, and you're basically going to spend a lot of time doing it, which is always good when you're selling out this kind of money for a game. You want to make sure you get enough involvement that you're actually making that investment worth it. So, anyway, so final word. It's a good game. If you're looking for something to play, definitely pick this game up. If you're already an Assassin's Creed fan, it's a no-brainer. If you're looking to break in, absolutely buy it. And guys, go off and enjoy and do some pillaging. Thanks for watching. Take care, and I will catch you all next time.